A comfortable retirement is a part of the American dream.
Recently, the U.S. Senate held hearings on new rules to make retirement investing safer for all Americans. Managing Director of Rebalance IRA Scott Puritz is a nationally recognized authority on retirement investing and was asked to provide the Senate with expert testimony on the subject. Under consideration by the Senate are new rules that require financial advisors to act in the best interests of their clients and to disclose the real cost of the investments they recommend, meeting what is called a fiduciary standard.
Over 30% of our clients come to us directly from having, for lack of a better phrase, a suboptimal relationship with a brokerage firm. At our firm, we sometimes refer to these clients as brokerage refugees. The story we see over and over again is all too familiar. A client at a brokerage firm who is stunned to find out that their so-called trusted retirement investment advisor does not have a fiduciary responsibility.
Labor Secretary Thomas Perez compared the new rules to standards required of other trusted professionals.
When you go to a doctor or a lawyer, they have a medical and legal obligation to put your best interests first. The Labor Department's conflict of interest rulemaking is about making sure that the same set of rules, best interest of the consumer, apply to when you are getting help in retirement.
The new rules are designed to level the playing field between commissioned brokers and advisors who already adhere to the fiduciary standard. According to Senator Elizabeth Warren, that would be good for the industry as well as for everyday Americans.
Hardworking Americans like the Florida firefighters and teachers who devoted their careers to protecting the public shouldn't have to worry about whether their financial advisors are planning to get rich by playing roulette with their customers' retirement savings. Hardworking advisors like Mr. Puritz shouldn't have to compete with these schemes. I am glad the Department of Labor is working to fix this problem. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
For all Americans saving for retirement, the stakes are high. Paying just 2.5% more in fees can dramatically reduce a retiree's nest egg, as the effect of compounding takes its toll over a lifetime of investing.
Senator, thank you. That's an excellent question and really gets to the heart of this matter from an economic point of view, from a return point of view. If someone had $100,000 and they were in an all-growth stock, which historically has returned 7.2% a year, that account would double every 10 years. So in the 30-year time frame, $100,000 would become $800,000, real considerable wealth creation. By contrast, if you reduce that down to 5%, which is really the fee delta that we see in the marketplace, that $100,000 only grows to $400,000, or half the amount of money. So that's what's at stake here.
Thank you, Mr. Acting Chairman.
The Department of Labor's new rules are designed to save investors the billions of dollars they lose each year due to conflicted investment advice. One way to avoid that risk right now is to make sure your advisor is a registered fiduciary. To learn more, visit RebalanceIRA.com.